One of the things that we can alter, depending on what the application of the shredder is going to be used for, is the drive, in other words, how we're providing the torque to the shredder. The simplest way, and historically the one that's been made the most, is an electric drive shredder. SSI does something what we call direct electric drive, meaning we take an electric motor, and we connect it directly to a gearbox, directly into the shredder. There's no belts, there's no gears other than the planetary reducer that gets the speed right. We have the electric motor driving the gearbox through the SSP, which is the severe shock load protection coupling. And there needs to be a coupling anyway to tie the motor to the gearbox. This coupling has a friction clutch in the middle of it that limits the amount of torque that can be put into the gearbox. The direct electric drive is the least expensive. It's the most efficient. It doesn't have a lot of components that dissipate a lot of energy. It's very reliable. Main thing is it's simple. It doesn't require a lot of maintenance. It's the easiest thing to do, and everybody would want to do that if they could. Unfortunately, that doesn't give you a lot of options for how speed and other stuff is fixed. It's just bang, it's running, that's the end of story. So we have a smart drive package that we then can control the speed of the motor, we can do ramp starts, we can do a bunch of other things with that motor that make the shredder a little more usable than just a straight electric shredder. The other thing that everybody really likes about it is you get variable speed. In many applications, you either need to adjust the speed of the shredder to account for what's downstream. The other one is that we have a lot of times where we're shredding fairly easy to shred material and we want to get a lot of it through the machine, so let's turn the speed up and go for it. So the smart drive, you can sort of meter the electricity into that motor and bring it up to speed with a much less of an inrush. The smart drive, because it's smooth or sort of controls the amount of power going into that motor, we can control how much energy and how much thermal energy is going into that motor, and we can let that motor reverse far more often per hour. And we have actually set up some machines on demonstrations where we're reversing every 3 seconds continuously for 24 hours and never had an issue with the motor.